The accusation that Kelly Donahue flashed the racist hand sign is also known as this. What is total bullshit?
That is right.
Okay, this is just getting ridiculous. Apparently, some Jeopardy viewers demanded an apology, claiming that this moment was the returning champion Kelly Donahue flashing the white power hand sign on Jeopardy, guest hosted by Anderson Cooper.
Our returning champion, a bank examiner from Winthrop, Massachusetts, Kelly Donahue.
Snopes is calling out this ridiculous claim, and Donahue apologized, but for some, this still is not enough. They are demanding to find everything racist and or offensive. Like two-time Jeopardy champ Jennifer Morrow, who tweeted, I'm a longtime Snopes fan, but this is a rare case where I urge for more skepticism. We Jay alums have been discussing this situation since last night. Many pressed the champ to clarify his intent. Today he made a post saying it was the number 3, no more, no less. However, many noted that a photo of Frank Sinatra making the same hand symbol, obviously pre-modern connotations, have been the champ's Facebook profile header since 2018, indicating an affinity for the gesture. They asked for a clear response, do you support these hate groups or not? The champ's response, he erased his social media profiles, post comments, the Sinatra header, Facebook blank, Twitter deleted, Insta locked. It's easy to say, any similarity is a coincidence. I do not support white supremacy. He has not, so we remain troubled by this. What is perpetually offended, Anderson? This is the photo of Sinatra. He was hanging out with Ed Sullivan and gave the okay sign, not white supremacy or anything more. It has been used as a hand sign for okay for a long time, previously in sign language, and also it's used by scuba divers, for example. So this is the apology Donahue posted, and you can see from the photos, on each of his appearances and wins, he holds up the number of his fingers for his show intro. I just wanted to clear something up about my recent appearances on Jeopardy, the greatest game show of all time. Competing on Jeopardy was the thrill of a lifetime, and being a returning champion is something I'll never forget. Many of the great champions of old had a little signature hello they would do on screen when being introduced by Johnny Gilbert. I decided to count my victories. That's a 1, that's a 2, that's a 3, no more, no less. There wasn't a hidden agenda or any malice behind it. Had I managed to repeat as champion, you'd have been treated to a 4. Instead, we have a new returning champion who played a masterful game in Dana Schumacher Schmidt. I don't think I could have beaten her even if I had known Vancouver. She was that good in Double Jeopardy. Congratulations, Dana, and good luck. Comment responses to this thread on Twitter consists of a bunch of people saying he needs to apologize for and denounce white supremacy. But see, when you battle these people, people in the past have denounced and distanced themselves from it many times, and still people in the media claim they never did. Nothing will ever be good enough to make up for the sins they perceive you to be guilty of. Not everything is about race. I don't believe this man has privated social media because he is hiding or guilty of something. It's because he knows the crap storm that's going to come and has already begun. I am sure he is soon to lose his job and have his life destroyed over something I don't believe for a second he was actually doing. If it's not okay to assume every person of color you see is a gang member, it's not okay to assume every white person you see is a hateful racist. In a letter more than 400 Jeopardy alums signed, they claim the following. During his on-camera introduction, Kelly made a gesture with his hand that he has since claimed was an indication that he had won 3 games. However, this gesture was not a clear-cut symbol for the number 3. He held his thumb and forefinger together with his other 3 fingers extended and palm facing inward, and he tapped his chest. This, whether intentional or not, resembled very closely a gesture that has been co-opted by white power groups, alt-right groups, and an anti-government group that calls itself the 3%ers. Regardless of his stated intent, the gesture is a racist dog whistle. Some of the first people to notice this were not affiliated with Jeopardy in any way. They were viewers who couldn't believe what they'd seen, captured it on video, and shared it to Twitter. Among them were people of color who, needless to say, are attuned to racist messaging and not appreciative that the show allowed this symbol to be broadcast. They point out that Jeopardy does not, for example, allow people to use numbers like 666, 69, or 1488 as wagers in the game, with producers editing these occurrences out. But those things are usually done as an attempt to troll and are more blatantly intentional. I don't believe that is the case with Donahue. Most problematic to us as a contestant community is the fact that Kelly has not publicly apologized for the ramifications of the gesture he made. If something was being misconstrued, an apology and a total disavowal of any connection to white supremacist doctrines is called for. We saw that gesture air on television. We are among the public it affected, and we are a diverse group of people. People of color, religious minorities, and other marginalized groups already live in the United States and Canada that have structural and institutional racism, sexism, anti-Semitism, ableism, homophobia, and transphobia embedded into their history and function. They do, really? This group trying to speak for others besides themselves is kind of awful here, but as I pointed out, even when people, reactionaries, have decided a racist, apologize for such things, it's still not accepted or good enough, or folks deny the distancing happened at all. These people deal with microaggressions nearly every day of their lives, through words, actions, and assumptions that remind them on a constant basis that they are not the default, they are not the mainstream, they are not real citizens, and that is hard enough. These racism goggles, the idea of seeing racism everywhere, whether intentional or not, suggests a victim frame of mind. We cannot control what people read into things, what their interpretations of every little thing they see are going to be based on their personal experience and biases. The letter continues. We cannot stand up for hate. We cannot stand next to hate. We cannot stand on stage with something that looks like hate. We are ashamed to be associated with brands and identities that suffer the taint of hateful statements and actions, particularly if they go unchallenged by those at the top. Leaving this messaging unchecked will encourage others to attempt similar things in the future. Is the production team of Jeopardy prepared for more of this? Prepared for more attempts to disguise contempt as innocent gesturing? Prepared for the backlash and ramifications should one of these moments ever become tied to real-world violence? As people whose lives have been largely beneficially impacted by the show and its community, we really hope to see a statement and a disavowal of both this week's events, and we would like to see Jeopardy address Kelly's behavior. The whole okay sign being a racist sign claim started as a trolling move on 4chan. They knew how far it would be taken and that many reactionaries would take it and run with it as they seemed to want to be offended by everything and be able to virtue signal that offense to the world. These folks would have every dollar of Donahue's previous winnings stripped from him to lose his job and his family leave him and throw him in jail if they could. All for what they wrongly perceive as some coded attack on marginalized people. The bad is your word.